Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 131, Elements of College Mathematics, Section 1.1, Problem 11. This is question number 11 from Section 1.1. Find the equation of the line that passes through the point 3, negative 5 and has a slope of 0. So when we find the equation of a line, typically we go with y minus y1 equals m times x minus x1. And that will work fine for this, and we have another method that we can do it, and I'll show both for this. We can start with this one, because this is typically how you start. You start with this equation of y minus y1 equals m times x minus x1. So the given point, we can label the x-coordinate x1 and the y-coordinate y1. So our given point for this question is 3, negative 5. The 3 is the x value, it gets labeled x1. The negative 5 is the y-coordinate, it gets labeled y1. The slope is 0 means that m has a value of 0 as we fill in the formula. The formula, essentially half of it stays and the other half you have to put in a number value for. So I underlined the y1, the m, and the x1 in my equation of a line formula. And those values will have to have a number value inputted for them, and the rest of it can stay. So we start with y, that stays, doesn't have an underline. The minus stays. Y1 is negative 5. So again, pay attention to the negatives. There are two. One negative from the formula, the other negative from the fact that this 5 is a negative 5. And that'll eventually become y plus 5. Equals is next. M for slope is 0. Start the parentheses. X does not have an underline, it will stay. Minus does not have an underline, it stays. X1 has an underline, its value is 3. And we close the parentheses. And that is the answer, certainly not in its most simplified form. Now to simplify it, typically again you want y equals mx plus b, you want to solve for y. Now what happens here is when you clear the parentheses, the 0 times the parentheses, the whole right half of the equation goes away. You have y plus 5 equals 0, that minus a minus 5, I change it to y plus 5. And to solve for y, you bring the 5 on the other side, you get y equals negative 5. Or you can figure that you subtracted 5 from both sides of the equation. Now, that's one method of finding the equation of the line that passes through the point 3, negative 5 and has a slope of 0. You get y equals negative 5 as your final answer. The other option is, if you happen to remember that all horizontal lines have a slope of 0, form is y equals a number. If you happen to remember that, you'll get the same answer that we got this way, but a little bit easier. So because the slope is 0, as given in the question, that made me remember that the answer must be a horizontal line, and it must have the form y equals a number. So they don't ask you to draw the graph, but if you can, draw a quick graph. So the point that's given is 3, negative 5. So if you go over 1, 2, 3, and down 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, you would have this point here, over 3, down 5, and because it has a slope of 0, I know it's a horizontal line. And the form will be y equals a number, and the number is the height of the horizontal line. I could have gone right to y equals negative 5 with much less math. So if you remember that all horizontal lines have a slope of 0 and they have the form y equals a number, you'll get the answer a little quicker. If you don't remember that, you start with the equation y minus y1 equals m times x minus x1, and you'll get the same answer, and you'll waste maybe a minute of work, maybe 3 lines of work. So not that bad. But either way, same answer. The answer is y equals negative 5.